sweeps, they actually hold the weight of everything on the sweeps. They got the center pole, the Aki clutch that we still use, and the 1901 General Electric motor that we still use. They got the 1909 Wurlitzer Monster Military Band organ to make the music. They got rail freight from Denver to Burlington, and they got technical assistance on how to put it together. And the three commissioners who bought it got fired. The taxpayers were furious that they'd wasted their hard-earned tax money. There were three of them, none of them ever served in office again. But fortunately, they have enough sense to invest about another $800 and build this building around it. And the building was made mostly out of wood salvaged from other buildings that have been torn down here on the fairgrounds. And now that old building out of the recycled wood and the carousel nobody wanted is a National Historic Landmark. So I guess those three commissioners got the last laugh after all. It ran for most of its life once a year during county fair, sometimes twice, county fair and Longbridge's rodeo. But initially when they bought it, it ran for just those 2 years during county fair. And then the Great Depression and the Dust Bowl hit. And we had dirt storms here that were so bad, you guys, this time of day it was almost as dark as night, that it didn't rain, the crops failed, the wind blew, the dirt blew. They couldn't afford to have the county fair. And so all these buildings were closed down. And they actually stored feed for animals in this building. Corn stalks and feed sheets and things and that. I've been told it wasn't loose, it was on the stalk. But they just dumped it in a window up there on top of everything. They didn't take the motor, the animals, the paintings, the organ, anything out. So in the late 30s when they started the fair again, it was a mess. And we've been told there were people who just wanted to get rid of it. But fortunately, the voice of reason won out. They scrubbed it down good with soap and water. They put on some varnish, cleaned out under the platform, and started to run for once a year during county fair. But the organ did not work, because when you got gray, you got rats and mice. And it works a lot the same principle as that player piano with bellows and tubing and the leather belts and the rats and mice. It destroyed all of that. And the roof had leaked, of course, and at some point somebody, I think, had fallen through the top. So the County Bridge and Road crew that was in charge of running it hooked up a record player and loudspeakers. And for about the next 40 years, you listen to country and western while you rode the carousel. That changed, though, in 1976, because not only was it the country's birthday, the bicentennial for our country, the state of Colorado celebrated their 100th birthday. They were 100 years old. And the legislature gave every county some money to do something to celebrate. Kit Carson County used that money as a down payment on getting the organ restored. At that point, it was in such bad shape, they put it in bushel baskets and cardboard boxes in the back of a horse trailer. All but to Colorado Springs, and a man named Art Rebrooks put it back together. They set it in the day before the 76 County Fair. There are only three Wurlitzer Monster military band organs, the biggest one they made left in existence, and the other two are in private collections, so this is the only one you have a chance to hear. I like to talk about the oil painting snacks. They are oil on fine muslin. Of course, they were all dirty and a lot of them had rips and tears. They located an art conservator in Denver whose name was John Pogsiva, and he took them into his shop a few at a time. He and a gentleman named Bill Morton cleaned them, patched them, and saved about 98% of the original paint on the oil paintings. Then Will came out here and he used those same fine art restoration techniques on the animals. He worked from early spring to late fall for 2 years. Lots of cotton balls and Q-tips right here on site. He didn't take the animals off or anything. He thought he was going to have to strip them. But what he found is that by very carefully removing 1981, there was an antique theft ring operating in this area. They literally broke in one dark and stormy night. Our alarm system was down. And their intent was to take the lion. They had him all unfastened, but he must have been too heavy. So they took four little inner row animals instead. They're the ones with the red, white, and blue ribbons at the tops of their poles. The next day, the repairman came. We discovered they were gone right away. He called the police. The FBI was involved. It was advertised internationally. But the way we got them back is the tale of a woman scorned. That the story is one of the women affiliated with this group got mad at her boyfriend. She went to the police, turned them in. They raided a warehouse in Salina, Kansas, and our little animals were there. So we put them on a flatbed and had a parade down Main, and they've been home ever since. So you guys, we have rules to protect that original pain and a couple to protect you. Remember, you only get on one animal, and when you do, one person per animal, and you ride facing forward with legs straight down to the sides. It's okay to use the stirrups. You just kind of watch that they don't beg and climb around a lot. We leave the reins alone because that causes damage up here, so we don't use the reins and we hang on to the brass pole instead. If you guys are going to stand next to your little guy, you stand toward the interior, hang on to the pole, hang on to them. And that is one of the rules for your safety that they have, is hang on to that brass pole whether you think you need to or not, because it does go faster than most carousels. It's up to about 10 to 12 miles an hour. And here's an interesting fun fact that in 1905, when this was made, the speed limit in most cities was 10 miles an hour. So this one is faster than the speed limit in town. So hang on to that brass pole whether you think you need to or not. And then once you've chosen your steed or your chariot, stay put. Don't get up and walk around until it comes to a total stop at the end of the ride. We'll come in, we'll load up, get what we want to ride. Then when the ride's over, you can drop your token and come in and take pictures if you're not. Oh, you're going to ride? Cool.
I want to stand.
Yeah, or there's also then the chariots too. So drop your tokens in the gumball machine, walk around on the concrete to choose what you want to ride, and we will go for a spin.
I guess I can walk around after. Okay.